Tonight, cruise ship quarantine. We're hearing from a Minnesotan who was stuck with thousands on a cruise liner with dozens of confirmed coronavirus cases.
Plus, a mother and son are dead, and an investigation is ongoing after a gruesome double homicide over the weekend.
And later, the Duluth City Council takes action on this eyesore after illegal dumping has turned it into quite the mess.
From CBS 3 Duluth, this is the CBS 3 News at 10.
Good evening, I'm Kristen Bakke.
And I'm Anthony Matt, thanks for joining us. The Grand Princess cruise ship has been plagued by COVID-19 cases for several days now.
Yes, thousands of passengers were stuck in their rooms while officials tried to find a place for the ship to dock. Earlier today, Reg Chapman talked with a Minnesota woman on the ship.
You could hear passengers aboard the Grand Princess cheer as the ship makes its way into Oakland Port.
At least we feel like we're moving forward.
For the past 4 days, they've been confined to their rooms after several on board tested positive for COVID-19. Barb Harris says she is excited about the plan that eventually gets them home to Minnesota.
They have decided that the people who are sick, they're going to be the first ones to get off, and they will take them to either hospitals or some kind of care facility.
Native Californians will get off the ship after that. They'll be taken to Travis Air Force Base for a 14-day quarantine.
Then those of us from other states, like Van and I from Minnesota, will get off next, and we will go to either Georgia or Texas at an Air Force Base in those two states.
Harris says she feels lucky that her room has a balcony where she can get fresh air daily.
It really is a help. You don't get so claustrophobic. Otherwise, the way you would a small inside stateroom, that's got to be really tough.
It could take 2 more days before this Minnesota couple is able to leave the ship.
It's very similar to when your plane gets delayed at the airport. You can jump up and down and complain all you want. Doesn't change a thing. So we're just going with it. It is what it is.
They say being confined to a cruise ship room for days has only made their relationship stronger.
She's a pleasure to be with, even in close quarters like this.
We figured if we could survive this, we'll be together forever.
Both Harris and Herman are healthy and have not shown any signs of the virus. They hope the next 2 weeks in quarantine goes fast.
City leaders say they're watching and waiting for coronavirus to arrive in Duluth. In the meantime, they're doing what they can to prepare. Duluth Fire Chief Sean Creget says the city has an emergency operations plan along with the county and the state. He says they've gone through and updated what they can, talked with the school district, and made sure they have protective gear like masks and gloves. Creget also says they've added questions for 911 dispatchers to ask, better identifying people who might be sick with coronavirus.
Although we've been looking at our plans and what we would do, nothing too specific yet because it still hasn't quite hit an alarming state in the local area.
Creget says there's not a whole lot they can do to stop coronavirus from reaching the Northland, but they're encouraging everyone to protect themselves by washing their hands and staying home if you do get sick. Meanwhile, the Minnesota legislature has approved nearly $21 million to fund coronavirus preparations. It's unclear when or how that money will be distributed.
In Wisconsin, a second person tested positive for coronavirus. The state confirmed the results today. The patient is in Pierce County, just west of Eau Claire, near the border with Minnesota. They were exposed to the virus while traveling in the U.S. They're currently isolated at home. County officials are working to figure out who may have had contact with this latest patient.
Dave's here for a quick look at the weather. Everyone in the newsroom was talking about that moon tonight. Mm-hmm. My goodness, just massive.
And it's easy to see because of high air pressure keeping the clouds down around our region. So let's dial our scope down from the moon to the ground, and we'll take a live look at what's happening in Ashland right now. And you can see that the road is clean and clear, and it sure looks like the bay is open. Calm conditions will be with us thanks to higher pressure taking over, keeping a pair of lows at bay, at least during the day on Tuesday. Come Tuesday night, there's a trough of lower pressure you can see trying to bubble out of Montana and Wyoming into the Dakotas, and that could bring a little bit of light snow. But for the daytime, lowers tomorrow should be partly cloudy to mostly sunny for the most part. Although once you start coming back home from work tomorrow afternoon, partly sunny leading to mostly cloudy, which could lead to a chance for a little bit of light snow, probably Tuesday night into Wednesday morning. We'll talk about how much might try to stick coming up in a few more minutes.
Thanks, Dave. More details surfaced today after a woman and her baby were killed on the Fond du Lac reservation. Today, family and friends tell us the victims are 27-year-old Jackie Defoe and her 18-month-old son, Kevin Jr. Friends also tell us Jackie was pregnant at the time of her death. Their bodies were found Sunday at a home on Lock Lane in Cloquet, not far from the Fond du Lac Indian Human Services building.
After an all-day manhunt, Cloquet police arrested Sheldon Thompson around 8 o'clock last night. The 33-year-old was found in a wooded area about 8 miles from the crime scene with help from a State Patrol helicopter and canine. He was treated at a hospital for what police called temperature-related issues and taken to the Carlton County Jail. He's expected to be charged with 2 counts of murder tomorrow morning. Police say Thompson knew the victims and may have had a past relationship with Jackie, but the motive for the crime is under investigation. Thompson has a lengthy criminal history. According to court records, he's been convicted of assault 6 times. Some of those were felonies, others misdemeanors. His most recent assault conviction was from 2016. He also was convicted of violating a domestic abuse no contact order 3 years ago. The Native community is no stranger to loss. As Indigenous women face high rates of violence, Jackie and Kevin Jr. are now part of a horrifying pattern. A gathering this morning was a memorial for Jackie and Kevin Jr. The healing walk was filled with pictures of them both celebrating the good times they had. The event also served as a rally honoring missing and murdered Indigenous women. Police say every time a woman falls victim to this epidemic of violence, it leaves a hole in the community.
It's unfortunate that it has to come to this, but we're going to try to come together as a community to get everything so we can try to prevent something like this happening again.
The Carlton County Attorney's Office hasn't said if Thompson will face 2 or 3 counts of homicide. We should know more around 10:45 tomorrow morning when Thompson is set to appear in court.
As the Fond du Lac community mourns the loss of Jackie and her son Kevin, Native leaders and advocates want victims of domestic assault to know you are not alone.
And there are resources available if you're seeking help, advice, legal counsel, or a safe place to go. CBS3's Jesse Slater has the details.
A shockwave jolted the Fond du Lac community this weekend as news broke that 2 of their own were found shot to death.
It's true what the community says. When it hits one, it hits everybody.
A violent crime of assault led to the tragic incident, something the Native community knows all too well. Deanna Rader with ACO wants victims to know there is a way out.
Creating the opportunity for victims to be able to speak and share their experiences without feeling judged.
There are a number of outreach programs across the Twin Ports that allows those going through trauma to seek help.
Giving them resources and providing that holistic approach in helping them heal, because we know once a victim decides to leave, it doesn't just end there.
While there is no exact way to end the cycle of violence, Rader says the most important step to healing is to show support.
Giving a voice to the victim, to the survivors.
Rader says these local groups are anonymous and would never force a victim into any situation.
To just know that you're going to be believed, that we're here for you, and we're here to listen to you.
If you or someone you know is a victim of domestic assault, you can reach out to a number of organizations for advice and help. You can find those numbers listed on our website, cbs3duluth.com.
A fire that destroyed 2 Grand Rapids businesses is still under investigation tonight. Grand Rapids fire officials say the blaze started in the basement of the Lakeview Behavioral Health Clinic around 9 o'clock Saturday night. It quickly spread to the nearby VFW and the Wells Fargo Bank. The bank had smoke damage while the clinic and VFW were destroyed. The state fire marshal's office is investigating what caused the fire. The Grand Rapids fire chief told us today he didn't have any information on whether or not the fire is suspicious. Lakeview behavioral health officials want their patients to know they have another Grand Rapids location and one in Hibbing.
Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, what the city council has decided to do about this messy stretch of road in Gary, New Duluth.
And later, what's being done to address a shortage of EMTs in Ely.
Record low temp for this state is 19 below from 1982. Tomorrow morning, it'll get into the single digits near the Canadian border, but should stay above zero. And then tomorrow afternoon, we warm up at least a bit. Way warmer than normal or not, I'll let you know coming up after just this short little break.
Get your news on the go, the CBS 3 mobile app.
When I went to Aspen Dental, they asked me, what's wrong? I go, I had rotting teeth in my mouth. My fiance hadn't seen me smile in 10 years. I have a child on the way here in the next 5 months. I would like to be able to smile in his first picture when he's born. They said, we can do that. If I would have known that I was going to be 50 times happier with dentures, I would have fixed it before.
At Aspen Dental, we're all about yes. Like yes, dentures start at $3.99 per arch. And yes to a 90-day denture money-back guarantee. Don't wait. Book at aspendental.com or call today.
You already know that Carry Toyota and Superior is a great place to buy and service your vehicle, but we have a lot more to offer every driver and not just people with Toyotas. We have the Yakima line of products for the adventure seekers, including roof racks, bike and kayak racks, and cargo carriers. We also have running boards, bed steps, and Axis brand tonneau covers like I put on my truck. And for those of you who like a clean vehicle, we have professional detailing services and all-weather floor liners from Toyota and WeatherTech. Carry Toyota and Superior, we have something for every driver.
Years fly by. Your retirement date keeps getting closer. Rather than spending another year worrying about retirement, get a second opinion on your financial strategy. Let us answer your questions and show you how tax reduction strategies can benefit your retirement. Go to mppl financial.com to download our free tax reduction checklist. Then call MPPL Financial this week for a complimentary second opinion consultation. A second opinion could be your best 2020 financial investment.
My name is Dan Metcalf. I'm a general surgeon and a colorectal surgeon at Memorial Medical Center. I bring a new set of skills to Ashland, and some of what Ashland would allow me is a culture that is very patient-centered. That's a really important part of surgery or medicine in general, is really getting to know the people that you're taking care of. I get the joy of seeing patients every day and taking care of people every day and learning about their lives as well as fixing them.
So Dish lets you share your TV with your family on multiple devices. Why?
Sweetie, forgot something.
Thank you.
Because we know one thing's for sure. It's a little less scary leaving home when you can take a little bit of it with you.
Share your TV on 5 devices. No extra charge. Dish. Tuned in to you.
CBS 3 Weather is brought to you by Carry Toyota. Now, the CBS 3 Duluth WeatherMax forecast with meteorologist Dave Anderson.
Well, let's talk about high temps today. They sure got pretty toasty over the weekend. My dad, today I was chatting with him, set up in Ely, hit 55 degrees. Well, today, thanks to a cold front, we stepped back about 20 degrees. Ely only topped out, well, 25 degrees. We stepped back 30 there. 29 International Falls, 35 in Proctor, 37 Hayward, not so bad. 45 in Ironwood, that's pretty decent if you're a spring fan waiting for things to happen. Although if you are a spring fan this week, I don't think too many things are going to happen because we don't have too many huge warm spells coming our way. Closer to normal this week than we were last week. We'll talk more about the temperature trends and what precip's going to do in a bit, but we'll take a look at the current conditions at the airport in Duluth. North wind, it's going 8 miles per hour. 27 is the current temp. Barometric pressure, 1,021 millibars. Getting up there again because higher pressure settling in to keep us on the clear side, at least through the daylight hours tomorrow. Tomorrow night, a little blip of lower pressure, a little trough coming in, could bring us a slight chance for a dusting to a half inch or so of snow. Temperatures right now in the Upper Peninsula run from 17 to 22. In northern Wisconsin, looks like they're going 23 to 28. Solon Springs Airport, again, one of the warmer spots here in northwestern Wisconsin. Superior, not so bad, though, at 25. 30 for Moose Lake, Willow River, Barnum, places like that. 21 Hibbing, 25 Grand Rapids, 21 Ely, and 19 International Falls. Low temps tonight. Could get as cool as 8 above for International Falls, and then probably the teens for much of the rest of our region. Big warm-up coming our way this week? No, like I mentioned, it probably isn't going to be coming our way. But it's not going to be bad either. Sunshine, thanks to high pressure, will be with us tomorrow. And then coming in tomorrow night, hard on the heels of that, the high goes away, the sunshine, is replaced by clouds. And Tuesday night into early Wednesday morning, we've got anywhere from 30 to even 60% chances for light snow showers and flurries. More like 30 in Minnesota, and could pick up steam and go towards 60% for northwestern Wisconsin. But by the time it's said and done here, come Wednesday morning, like I've been hinting at here, totals might just run a trace to a half inch. Not a big deal at all. And then after that, another little blast of sunshine comes our way. So here's the forecast coming our way for the week ahead. Tonight in Minnesota, clear to partly cloudy. Low temps, 8 inland, 18 by the lake. That's a 10-degree spread over about 150 miles. Now we take a look at what's happening in northwestern Wisconsin, and the low temps there should run about 15 to 17 above with that partly cloudy sky. Tomorrow during the afternoon hours in Wisconsin and Michigan, it should be mostly sunny during the day, but a little night flurry activity is possible. High temps upper 30s to lower 40s for tomorrow. And for Minnesota, about 35 to 40 for the high temps, with a mostly sunny day and a little night snow possible, which goes away to partial sunshine on Wednesday. Thursday gets a mixed chance, 40% shot. Low 40s, perhaps the best we're going to do this week for temperatures, because once we get towards Friday, it clears up, which is nice, but then temperatures stay in the low to mid 30s through the weekend, and the weekend does feature a grayer sky, and 30 to 50% chances for light snow that might add up to an inch or two here by Monday morning.
All right, still.
No complaints over the weekend. I think for the first time since maybe October, I spent more time outside than I did inside.
I think I did too. Finally shoveling out snowmobiles and working on a snowblower, adjusting the carburetor. Can't do that when the snow's out, no.
No, it doesn't make any sense.
Gotta wait till springtime.
Yeah, thanks, Dave.
The redevelopment of an historic Lincoln Park building could bring more affordable housing to a key corner of the Craft District. The city of Duluth is considering contributing public funds to the Esmond Building Project. A developer plans to renovate the building, making the ground floor 8,500 feet of retail space, and the top floor has 30 housing units. If the city contributes funding, 20% of the units will be required to be affordably priced. City housing officials say they're still finalizing all the plans.
So now this building is going to be redeveloped from top to bottom. And again, that's part of the challenge with getting pricing around it is it's not a new construction from ground up. It is taking this historic old structure and figuring out the best way to improve it and maintain the integrity of the building.
The rental rates will be set once the developer knows the project cost. If the developer doesn't need public funding, they won't be required to include affordable units.
The Duluth City Council approved the closure of a troubled street in the western portion of the city. This is what a section of 108th Avenue West in the Gary New Duluth area looks like. It's a common dumping ground for trash and furniture. Now, 300 feet of the road north of West Dixon Street to Beck's Road will be closed for at least the next 2 to 3 months, and possibly permanently. City officials will be conducting a traffic study as part of a larger conversation about managing waste for the city. Councilors Derek Medved and Janet Kennedy proposed the idea.
You know, when we talk about trying to solve the problem of illegal dumping, that's a big problem across the whole city. And so I think what Councilor Kennedy, and I don't want to speak for her, but you know, what we can do together is really start a conversation and really work towards, you know, how can we mitigate that?
It is unclear when the closure will go into effect, but Medved said he would like to see it closed sooner rather than later.
Still to come on Live Local CBS 3, there's a need for ambulance drivers on the range. What officials are doing to address a critical shortage.
CBS 3 Live Cams are brought to you by Kohler Chevrolet Buick GMC Cadillac. You're not just getting a car, you're getting Kohler.
Look at what just $10 a month will get you when you spend $5.99. A classy bedroom set, all four pieces, only $10 a month. 5-year financing on purchases of just $5.99 or more. And get free shipping with no minimum, only at Slumberland Furniture.
Flooring adds fashion to any room. Update your home with super fast vinyl plank flooring. Delaney is waterproof, easy to install, and has an attached pad in two colors, $179 a square foot. Right now, all Serta Perfect Sleeper mattresses are on sale. This Dortmund mattress has individually wrapped coils for a comfortable night's sleep and is available in a medium feel for only $567. Now, during Menards Think Spring Sale.
Save big money at Menards.
Our shower was like 20 years old and it was just in the worst condition. We had a new shower put in and it was acrylic and there's hardly any cleaning compared to the other one.
we decided to call Bath Planet.
And Wayne did contact us, and he made sure that it was a good time for us.
He came here at 8 o'clock in the morning. Job was done by 4 o'clock.
I'm so glad that we chose Bath Planet.
Come visit us in our new showroom at the Miller Hill Mall.
What are you thinking?
Thinking about burger, fries, and some pie.
You know it's 9 o'clock in the morning.
Well, then bring the pie first.
It's back and better than ever. Hurry in today for Perkins Burger, Fries, and Pie Combo for a limited time. Enjoy any burger, crispy fries, and a slice of our famous pie. It's dinner, dessert, and a deal only at Perkins.
In my Johnsonville commercial, they open on a game show set in the 70s. Today we got Johnsonville smoked sausage made with 100% premium pork. Some brands mix meats and add fillets, but not Johnsonville. Contestant number one bids the closest, so he wins a boat. And he says, I don't want that boat. I want the sausage. What if I told you that boat is filled with Johnsonville smoked sausage? And that's a smoked sausage commercial made the Johnsonville way.
Popular demand at Slumberland. Look at what $10 per month will get you. A Sealy luxury firm queen mattress with this modern upholstered base, $10 a month. Pay no interest for 5 years when you spend $5.99 or more. Look at what $10 will get you at Slumberland.
The 2020 Honda Rubicon at RJ Sport and Cycling.
My part-time service in the Army National Guard allows me to keep my community and those I care about safe from threats. Learn more about how you too can live and serve part-time close to home by visiting NationalGuard.com.
Watch Anthony Mack weekdays at 6 and 10 p.m. on live local CBS 3 Duluth.
The Ely Area Ambulance Service says they are in dire need of extra staffing for transports from Ely Hospital to Duluth and other facilities.
So some new jobs are opening up. They're hoping to have two new people on duty from 11 a.m. to 11 p.m. to help with transports. CBS3's Jenna Wells learned more about why these new positions are so necessary.
The Ely Area Ambulance Service is looking to add a second crew to their 22-person staff. Two new positions to help with transport. Longer hours, but at higher pay.
It's hard to find people to come to Ely to work in this field without paying them a livable wage. So we did a slight wage increase and in addition add in two people for 12 hours out of the day to help with that need that the hospital has.
The service's executive director, Jeff Galaski, says having a full staff is crucial for the region.
It's huge in rural Minnesota to have an ambulance service, and when a patient is critical and needs to get to tertiary care in Duluth or wherever, and helicopters aren't flying, we need to go by ground ambulance. And if we don't have the staff, that patient can't get transported.
Galaski says their service misses nearly 30% of transport requests each year due to understaffing. But the problem isn't just confined to Ely.
All hospitals on the Iron Range, they use a call down list, and everybody contacts the next appropriate ambulance service that's closest to them, and sometimes they get through that list and still nobody can take the transport.
But the additional staffing comes with a cost.
Right now we're planning the budget at a $45,000 deficit for 2020. Right now the Joint Powers contributes $5.05 per population towards the ambulance service, and we're looking at other funding opportunities to increase that.
Galaski says the Joint Powers Board is also considering using money from Ely taxpayers to help by collecting a portion of property taxes.
It's how much money do you put on a life is really what it comes down to, and what service do you want available in this area.
The Ely Area Ambulance Service is currently applying for grants in order to train newcomers. So once those grants are approved, the new job positions will be posted and ready for applicants.
All right, Kelly's here to talk about what's coming up in sports.
Big night. Former UMD scores his first NHL goal alert. We're going to talk about that. Plus, the Bucks sans Giannis Antetokounmpo. Can they pull off the win? Coming up next.
Catch Eye on Parenting every Thursday at 6 with me, Leanne Valdez, on CBS 3.
You gotta feel it to believe it. Get Extreme Internet starting at $19.99 a month for 1 year. With fantastic speeds from 60 meg up to 1 gig. Dynamic streaming video, so real you can feel it. Amplified in-home Wi-Fi and all the power you need to power it all. Get Extreme Internet starting at $19.99 a month for 1 year. Call 844-EXTREME2.
Spring is right around the corner, which means special spring bonus savings are back. For a limited time, you can get an extra $1,000 in spring bonus cash on a new Ford SUV. The all-new Escape has tech to give you peace of mind behind the wheel, while the redesigned Explorer will adjust to every road and any conditions. See for yourself why Ford is America's best-selling brand. Now with an extra $1,000 in spring bonus cash, get $6,250 in total cash on a 2020 Explorer. Hurry in to your local Northland Ford dealer today.
We know it can be scary when you're injured in an accident.
We know the insurance company can be unfair.
We know bills need to be paid.
But we also know what it takes to win.
We know what it takes to get our clients compensated.
And most importantly, we always fight to do the right thing for our community.
Nicolet knows.
Nicolet knows.
Nicolet knows.
Nicolet knows injury law.
Nicolet Law, Northern Minnesota's award-winning injury, disability, and bankruptcy law firm.
Your water softener needs salt. You buy it, lug it, pour it, over and over. Save salt and the hassle with a Culligan high-efficiency water softener. The world's best. Click or call Culligan Water and start saving today.
Continental Ski is having a store-wide winter flash sale March 14th and 15th. Check out our wide selection of winter gear and save 40% off all winter apparel, skis, and accessories. The Winter Flash Sale, only at Continental Ski and Bike in Duluth, Minnesota.
I grew up working in my family's supper clubs. This is where it started with us as far as the fish that we serve at Culver's today. We source the finest cod and batter each fillet by hand and always cook it to order. That beautiful golden brown color and flaky on the inside. The fish fry is a Midwest tradition. It's about coming together. It's families, friends. I love bringing this tradition to guests everywhere. Mom and Dad would be proud. Welcome to Delicious.
I don't believe there's another meteorologist in this area. He has the experience and years that Dave has. His experience, that's something that's really special to CBS 3.
He worked his way up from janitor up to a weather guy.
He's just like this bastion of knowledge.
Get to know Dave Anderson weekday nights on Live Local CBS 3.
Following a season of ups and downs and many high, sky-high expectations, the University of Minnesota Duluth men's hockey team's postseason journey officially begins this Friday. UMD capped off the regular season with a 5-game win streak. This weekend, the Bulldogs finished off the St. Cloud State Huskies with a commanding sweep, outscoring the Huskies 10-2 in total. Sorry, Tony, he went there. In addition to solidifying their opponent for the first round of the NCHC playoffs, and also inches, UMD also inches up a spot to number 4 in the latest USCHO polls. UMD has clinched home ice and will face Miami, Ohio in the first round of the NCHC playoffs. The best of 3 series begins on Friday. Should the Bulldogs win Friday and Saturday, a Sunday game will not be necessary. Winner heads to the NCHC Frozen Faceoff down in St. Paul at the X. Puck drop is at 7:07 p.m. Speaking of UMD, we've got a first NHL goal alert from the former UMD forward, Mikey Anderson, who sniped in his first goal as a professional hockey player tonight. The LA Kings playing Colorado. The Hill Murray alum gets this one through traffic. This is Anderson's 5th start as an NHLer. And Giannis Antetokounmpo sitting out for the 2nd straight game. Bucks taking on Denver tonight. Bucks found themselves in a rare deficit late in the second, trailing by 12. Kyle Korver cuts into the single digits with the 3. He led the team in scoring tonight, but Bucks do fall 109-95, the final. Major League Baseball, the NHL, and NBA and Major League Soccer released a joint statement tonight announcing that they are temporarily banning locker room access to the media over coronavirus fears. The statement says members of the media will have access to players and coaches in designated locations outside of locker rooms and clubhouses. However, players must remain at least 6 feet from reporters. This applies to both games and practices. That's really hard because you have to hold a mic out 6 feet. Can you imagine? That's so hard. Following a 20-win season, a second-place finish at the NSIC tournament last week, UMD Women's Hoops is going dancing. It was late last night that the Bulldogs found out their NCAA tournament fate. UMD earned themselves the second seed in the Division II tournament. Bulldogs head to Central Missouri State in Warrensburg, Missouri for the first round starting Friday, March 13th. The journey begins on Friday. UMD takes on Fort Hays State, the number 7 seed down in Missouri. Bulldogs met the Tigers previously this season in November, where they lost by 8. Tip-off Friday, 2:30 p.m. Yesterday was a bit of a heartbreaker for the UMD men's basketball team. The team was just barely squeezed out of the NCAA tourney by the narrowest of margins, finishing 9th overall in the Central Region rankings. The top 8 advanced. Still one historic season for the Bulldogs. The 6 seniors that they graduate finished with a 22-9 overall record, just 3 years after they finished 4-25 as freshmen. The team notched also the most wins for the program since 1996 and the 1997 season. And the big dance here in Minnesota for the girls' high school basketball season begins on Wednesday. We have a solid batch of teams here in the Northland competing for a shot at a state title. 3 teams will make their way down to Minneapolis this week. In Class A, Cromwell Wright will have the number 2 seed. Class AA, Duluth Marshall is unseeded and will play the 3 seed. And in Class AAA, Hermantown is unseeded and will face the number 1 seed on Wednesday morning. Taking a closer look at the schedules, Cromwell Wright faces Belgrade on Thursday afternoon at 3 p.m. Duluth Marshall takes on New London Spicer on Wednesday at 8 p.m. And Hermantown will face De La Salle on Wednesday at 10 a.m. That is going to do it for sports tonight. We'll be right back after the break.
CBS 3 Closed Captioning is brought to you by Essentia Health, St. Mary's Heart and Vascular Center. Heart disease is the leading cause of death in the U.S. Ask your doctor how to keep your heart healthy.
At Super One Foods, we go to great measures to deliver you with top quality meat every day. Try our Smithfield pork loin stuffed chops, only $1.99 per pound. And get chicken drumsticks or thighs for just 88 cents per pound. Plus, we provide the best of the best in fresh produce. Get cantaloupe or honeydew melon just 66 cents per pound and fresh Brussels sprouts for just 99 cents per pound. Through all that we do, we've got you in mind. Super One Foods, serving you lower prices and better choices.
Imagine yourself in a new Toyota.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Sweet.
With great deals, get ready to turn your dreams into reality.
Right now, during Toyota's Ready, Set, Go sales event, you can get $1,000 TFS APR cash when you finance a new 2020 Toyota RAV4.
Ready, Set, Go get your Toyota today.
Toyota, let's go places.
It's our 80th birthday at DQ, so you're invited to celebrate with BOGO 80-cent Blizzard Treats. Buy one Blizzard and get a second Blizzard for just 80 cents through March 15th. It's the ultimate party favor. Cue the confetti drop. By that, we mean M&M's, Oreo, cookie dough, BOGO, for just 80 cents. Whatever your favorite flavor, that's a Blizzard for you and a plus one. DQ, happy, tastes good.
Get ready to travel in comfort and style with your chance to win a Winnebago at Black Bear Casino Resort. Saturdays in March from 6 to 9 p.m., 3 lucky winners each hour will score up to $1,000 cash. On grand prize night, March 28th, 11 players will win the cash, and one winner will drive off in their brand new 2020 Winnebago Mini Winnie. Over $100,000 in cash prizes. Earn entries starting March 1st. Visit BlackBearCasinoResort.com for more information and make the bear your place.
Shopping for a new kitchen at Skip's has never been better. Take home your dream kitchen today with Skip's new Glenwood and White cabinets. Enjoy freedom and flexibility with your own movable island today. You can rely on Skip's for quality and durability at affordable prices. Stop by with your measurements and see how you can take home beautifully painted or stained cabinets today at a truly affordable price. Visit us online at skipshomecenter.com or stop in to see our showroom at 4728 Rice Lake Road, Duluth.
Men's wardrobe provided by Mainstream Fashions for Men. Our buy one, get one for a buck suit and sport coat sale is now in progress. Hundreds of options. Mainstream, downtown Duluth.
All right, Dave, I don't think we're going to see many of those 50s like we saw this weekend, huh?
No, not this week. 30s and low 40s, the best we're going to manage. Sunny day on Tuesday. Tuesday night, a slight chance for light snow, then partial sunshine Wednesday, followed by a mix on Thursday. Then the next round of precip could be for the weekend.
Thanks for joining us.
We'll see you tomorrow.